we are interfacing a gas sensor. What type of gas sensor we are using? We are using MQ2. It is also written on top of the sensor. This MQ2 determines the concentration of gases in the atmospheric air. What are the variety of gases that this sensor can determine? This sensor can determine LPG, carbon monoxide, alcohol, smoke, methane. So these are the variety of gases that this particular sensor can be used for sensing. So in our application today, I'm going to use this sensor for determining LPG. Okay. So what application I'm planning to use? See, in households, we are using invariably in all the households, we are using LPG gas cylinders. Sometimes when the cylinder's valve is not properly closed, or if there is some kind of a leakage in the LPG gas, if it is not taken care of appropriately, if the housewife or somebody who is using that particular LPG turns the lighter on, it may result in a very serious accident, fire accident. So to avoid that, what I wanted to do today, I am going to use a sensor. This sensor would determine the concentration of LPG in the atmospheric air, or I place the sensor in the close proximity of the LPG cylinder. In case if there is any, you know, accidental leakage of LPG during night time or during the time when the family is out of home for some reasons, this LPG gas sensor would detect the concentration of LPG, and then that would pass on this information to Arduino, and the Arduino should fire an alarm with a huge high decibel noise, so that the owner of the house or the housewife, whoever it is, get an intimation that something wrong is happening in the LPG. So we have to handle that cautiously. So for that application, we are using a gas sensor. So job of this LPG sensor or MQ2 sensor is to detect the concentration of LPG in air. Concentration of these gases is normally represented in parts per million, ppm. Say, for example, if the sensor output is giving a concentration as 1000 ppm, it means in 1 million gas molecules, in 1 million atmospheric air molecules, we have 1000 molecules of LPG. That's what it is. So once the concentration level of LPG exceeds a certain threshold, we can determine that there is some unwanted thing happening, some kind of a leakage happening. Okay, this is a simple example that I'm giving. You can extend this concept to a lot of other places, like wherever this kind of serious gas leakages are possible. Say, for example, in mines, in deep mines, when people are, you might have seen a lot of accidents when people go into coal mines or some kind of tunnels. This kind of hazardous gas leakages will kill people in no time. So this kind of gas sensors can be used as a artificial nose. That's the proper word that I can use, which can detect the concentration of some hazardous material and intimate this for you, so that you can save a lot of lives. So that is the idea behind using this sensor. In the bottom view of this sensor, if you see, there are 6 pins, okay, arranged in a circular fashion like this. This is the bottom view. So there are 6 pins in the arranged in a circular fashion. These 6 pins are grouped in 3 pairs. The topmost pair, or the vertical pair, we call it as a coil. So there is a heating coil element here. So this coil, we call it as heating element H. Okay. So how do we connect this heating element? One end of this heating element, we connect it to power supply voltage. Other end of the heating element is connected to ground. You can connect any one of the heating element to power supply. There is no polarity here. Either this or this. One terminal has to be connected to power supply. Another one has to be connected. Okay. The ones that are represented in blue, we call them as terminal A, and this is terminal A. And the one which is represented in green is terminal B. Whichever heating coil that you connect to power supply, we call those two pins as A. Say, for example, if I connect this heating element coil to power supply line, then I would call these two terminals as A. Why? Because you need to short circuit these two coils, these two pins. Okay, so I take a wire and I short circuit these two, and I connect them also to +5 volt. So invariably, all these 3 pins should go to +5. In the bottom section, I connect these two pins B and B together, and I connect a resistor, typically a 10K resistor, and this meeting point is the analog output. Okay, probably I would give that a very clear indication for you. So this is my, this is the LPG which I wanted to sense if there is any leakage or not. So typically I would put the sensor in the very close proximity of this LPG. So typically I would put the sensor here somewhere in the close proximity. So how would I connect the sensor? The sensor has a coil internally. So one point of the sensor is the heating element H. The other pair of the heating element we connected to ground. So that completes one circuit. The second one is I take A pins. So I connect this A and this A together. And that also I connected to plus 5 volts. So invariably all the three pins on the top section are connected to plus 5 volts. In the bottom section, the green pins are B pins. I take them, short circuit them. I use a resistor to ground them. The meeting point of B pin and the resistor, I take the analog output and connect it to analog pin A. So this is the analog output. So this is the sensing part on the left hand side. Right side is the control part. Of course, as usual, in order to monitor what is the analog output that is coming, we connect a pseudo UART here. This is just to monitor the data that is coming from the sensor. And to the right, we put the control circuit. What is the control circuit? It's a simple buzzer. It gives you a positive and a negative terminal. Negative terminal I connect to the ground line. Positive pin you can connect to any of the available free pins. So in this case, I'm connecting to pin number 11. You can connect to any pin so that the buzzer gives you a loud output in case if there is a gas leakage. Now let us test this sensor in the Tinkercad. So as usual, before we actually connect the sensor to Arduino, we have to first check the operating principle of the sensor. Let us connect the sensor part to the left hand side. So this is my gas sensor. So it is given as if all the pins are symmetrically arranged in the schematic here. In practical scenario, it is arranged in a circular fashion, which means there is no way we can insert this in a breadboard. I hope you are understanding what I'm saying. So if this is arranged in a circular fashion, you cannot actually insert this in a breadboard. Okay, so but in this simulation, it is possible. So what am I doing here? So first I take the power supply wire. This is heater coil 1. So you can see this terminals. This is heater 1. This is A2. This is A1. Okay, so let us take the plus 5 volt. I connect this to red. That is the first connection. Second connection, we have to ground this fellow. The bottom section of the heater element to ground. So that completes the heating element of the sensor. Then we have to give the connection for A lines. So this A and this A are internally connected. And, okay, so I have short circuited these two pins and I connected that one to power supply. So that completes my one end, so visible, and give it to blue. So that is the A lines. In the bottom, we have the ground lines. So let us first short circuit these two. Then we take a resistor. One end of the resistor we connected to this. The other end of this resistor we connected to ground. So that is my ground. So this is where we have to take the output, the meeting point of resistor and the B terminals. Okay, so before we basically connect that to Arduino, let us take a multimeter and check the analog output voltage. So the ground terminal I connected to ground, the positive terminal I connected to the analog output. Analog output is the meeting point of resistor and point B. Meeting point of resistor and point B. This one. Let me change that to pink. So I'm not doing any coding. I'm using Arduino only for power supply and ground. Let us see how this sensor works. Okay. So by default, when nothing is happening, it is giving me an output of 494 millivolt, which is 0.5 volt roughly. What happened if you click the sensor? It is giving you a simulated version of gas. Okay. Some are you able to see this gas, all of you? Is it visible for you all? Okay. Now, when this gas is brought close to the sensor, you can see the analog output voltage being increased. So, as the concentration of the gas increases, you can see that the sensor's output voltage is drastically increased to 1.66 volt. Okay, so if the gas is moved away from the sensor, I'm just simulating the situation in the real time case. Under normal cases, when there is no gas leakage, this fellow gives you a constant 0.5 volt or 400 and some millivolt. And when the gas leakage happens, when the sensor is subjected to leakage of gas, the voltage is increasing drastically. This change in voltage is what is the information that we have to capture in the Arduino. Okay, this void setup, void loop, either LPG concentration equal to zero. So this is the variable which I use for capturing the concentration of LPG. So LPG concentration is equal to analog read of channel zero, A0. So what I do? So as usual, I put the information into computer and see what is the data. For that, we need to initialize the serial port. So serial.begin 9600 baud. Coding is very simple if you understand the concept. And then I have to put this serial.println. println. What I wanted to print, this LPG concentration I want to. So do this every 500 milliseconds. So nothing, we are opening the serial port. We are reading the concentration of LPG from analog A0 and then printing that information to computer just to know what is the value of information that is coming. We wanted to know that. Only then we can take control action. So let us disconnect this multimeter and give connection from analog A0 to this. So this pink wire is the signal information. So once you connect this to A0, we push the information to computer. Go to text mode and start the simulation. So in the serial monitor, what we are getting is 113. Now let me give the concentration of this gas. The gas is somewhere in the farther place, so concentration is still going down. So the moment I bring this the gas slowly to the proximity of the sensor, you can see that the ADC's value is gradually increasing. Okay, so the peak, the complete, when the core of the gas is in the middle of the sensor, what we are getting is 339. So that is the maximum value we are getting. So the maximum value of ADC is equal to 339. So once the gas is not affecting the sensor, if it is in the farthest point, the minimum value is somewhere 85. ADC minimum is equal to 85. So that this point corresponds to there is no LPG leakage. So when the ADC's information is 85 or low, or in the range of 85, we are 100% sure that there is no LPG leakage. But whereas when the information is somewhere here, we are sure that the LPG leakage has happened. But we cannot wait for this complete data to, when the ADC data to increase to this level. So we need to find a threshold somewhere in the middle. So I can fix a threshold or a set point, we call it that, or set point or threshold somewhere at 250 or so, or even 200 for that matter. Okay. We reduce it still further, probably under normal cases when we, when you cook or something, it also emits some kind of LPG gas. So at that time also it will fire alarm, fake alarm. So that I don't want. So 200 is a cautious number. So if the ADC emits anything above 200, then straight away my LPG is leaking. So that is a warning symbol for me. So in that case, what should I do? I need to turn a buzzer on. So that's what I have to do. So take a buzzer. So here is a buzzer. So one end of the buzzer I connected to, positive of the buzzer I connected to pin number 11, negative of the buzzer I connected to ground. So this 11th pin I have to turn on. When I should turn on? When the ADC value crosses, when the ADC value crosses 200, 200 is the threshold. So let us go to the code. So when, if ADC concentration is above 200, what should I do? I should turn on digital write 11th pin yeah, high. Else, it's only a single statement, so there is no need for me to put any brace. Else, the if statement has only one statement, so there's no point in writing a brace for this. Else, in case if the ADC value is less than 200, we don't consider that as a genuine gas leakage. So in that case, I don't want the buzzer to go on, so I make it. So if you are making a digital write, it is necessary that you have to make that as an output pin. So pin mode 11th pin is configured as output. So I'm taking an if condition based on the concentration of LPG. If LPG concentration is above 200, why are you fixing this 200? Okay, this is a decision that I made. Okay, based on the trial and error, you can always make a decision on of your choice. Even put an appropriate threshold value here. Let us put this code, go to code and stop this motion. So as usual, you are getting 85. So I am simulating the gas situation here. I'm bringing this gas to the close proximity of the sensor. So it is keeping quiet till the number reaches 200. The moment it reaches 200, then it makes a sound. So the buzzer is giving you a sound. The moment the gas goes out of the concentration level goes below 200, the buzzer keep quiet. When it increases and then goes to, there is one function called tone, T-O-N-E, tone. The syntax is pin number, what is the frequency of the tone, and you can also determine the duration, but that is not needed. So I can put this tone, which pin I am interested in, 11th pin. You can say you can set it as 500 hertz, something of this sort. And if you don't want the tone, you can use no tone. And which pin you don't want the tone? 11th. So you can, instead of turning the buzzer simply on and off, we can use the tone function, which will give you the, you know, the tone of the buzzer, an appropriate frequency of your choice. So I just comment this. Now let us try and increase the concentration. This is giving you a better sound. Are you able to hear now? Probably if you reduce the time interval, it becomes more spontaneous. I given a delay of 500, so you can just minimize that to 100. The device becomes more spontaneous now.